Hallelujah. Let's rise on our feet and give him praise. It's worthy.
Jehovah, 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 Our two hands to heaven and magnify the name of the Lord at this time, everybody. Give God thanks for answered prayers all through the night. Give God thanks for encounters with the world all through the night. Give God thanks for light from heaven. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. Why don't you ask the Lord at this point, Jesus, the last of every event in the kingdom offers the best. Let this last word deliver to me the best of encounter. Go ahead and pray. Let this last word deliver to me the best of encounter. The last of every heaven's agenda is everybody's moment, everybody's time. Let this be my time of encounter. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Please, you may be seated. Let me welcome every one of us around the world at this time. In this last segment, which is very, very important, we've been looking at engaging the prayer of faith for fulfillment of prophecies. I'd like us to know that the prophetic agenda placed in our hand only provides guidelines. It only outlines the syllabus of God's agenda for the year. We now need to explore the facts that will empower us to secure the actualization of this agenda in our lives. We are told it's a year of freedom from all generational curses. When you are saved, you are restored with Christ, and you are made to sit together with him in heavenly places. And according to scriptures, curses are not permitted in heavenly places. He said, and there shall be no curse. So where you are seated is a no-go area for curses. Where you are seated, generational curses have no legal access. Come on, let me hear your loudest amen. Revelation 22 and verse 5, and verse 3, he said, and there shall be no more curse, for the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his people shall serve him. Now, you see, you are not only sitting in heavenly places. As you serve him, you become uncursable. For thou shalt serve the Lord thy God, and he shall bless. And when God blesses, who can curse? Come on, let me hear your amen. Well, this moment is declared your moment of total freedom from all curses and appearance of curses. Everybody in your natural lineage may have come on, may have been under that siege and is trying to get you on. But by the fact of redemption, where you are seated, curses have no access.
Amen.
As you are serving God, you are declared uncursable.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Numbers 23 and verse 8. How shall I curse whom God has not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord has not defied? There is no force of hell that can curse a man whom God has blessed. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
There is no force in hell that can place a curse on a man whom God has not cursed. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
But be careful here. The curse of the Lord is in the house of the thief.
That's right.
So don't steal.
That's right.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because it's not a devil that's cursing you. It's not a witch that is cursing you. It is God himself. Glory to God. Now see. But when you are blessed of God, you are uncursable by man.
Amen.
When you are blessed by God, you are uncursable by devils. When you are blessed by God, you are uncursable by witches. Come and say with me, I'm uncursable. Say with me, you come here, redemption has made me uncursable. Redemption has made me uncursable. Therefore, every effect of curses drops off anyone's life under the sound of my voice tonight. For surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, nor divination against Israel. Numbers 23:23. From now it shall be said to Jacob and to Israel, what has God wrought? No one will see the hand of the wicked on your life again. And if you are born again, if ye be Christ, then ye are Abraham's seed, and you are heirs according to the promise. So, you are a spiritual Jew. You are uncursable. Galatians 3 and verse 29. And it's not a Jew that is one outwardly, but the one that a Jew inwardly. Circumcision is of the heart and not of the letter, whose praise is of God. So every child of God is a spiritual Jew and is uncursable. I therefore stand on the authority of the word of God to command every impact of curses to drop off every life under the sound of my voice. Now be free in the name of Jesus. Marital spells are broken right now in the name of Jesus. Business and career spells are broken now in the name of Jesus. The curse and spells of barrenness are dropped now in the name of Jesus. It's my year of sudden turnarounds. Now listen to me. You need to possess that mentality.
God who created the world in 6 days cannot be handling your case in 1 week. No. He said, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, we shall be changed. Not in a century, in a moment. Now, watch. Now, right now, there are people here. The same way you walked in here last night is not the way you are walking out this morning. Because something is changing fundamentally about your life now. How do I mean? You are not permitted to suffer beyond the while. After you have suffered a while, establish and settle you. 1 Peter 5:10. You are not permitted to struggle beyond a while. So anything beyond the why is illegal. Anything beyond the why in your life, any concern beyond the why in your life is illegal. Amen. Get angry and get free. Get angry and get free. Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17, he said, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment. How long?
A moment.
Every affliction has a moment expiry date. Rados karande si karato pi katanota. Anything beyond a moment is out of order. Rade segetu shagira bayate sotia. Brekoto sizonia yetangego. That trouble, that concern around your life is declared over now. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. That humiliation is turning to an eternal weight of glory. Is turning to an eternal weight of glory. Hear what he said. He said, Psalm 30, verse 5, weeping may endure, but what? For how long? But for a moment. In his favor. For his anger endureth but for a moment. Hush. Weeping may endure for a night, not for nights. But joy cometh in the morning. No weeping is permitted to go beyond a night. So whatever passed beyond a night is out of order. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I decree the arrival of your joy. Today, he said, joy cometh in the morning. Your joy has come today. It has come this morning. Your joy 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 has come this morning. Radescori bayaka tangleroto sizano. No, get seated. I have heard thee in the time accepted, and the day of salvation have succored thee. Behold, now. When? Now. Come on now, when? Now is the accepted time. Behold, now. We serve a now God. Now. He said, now, today, I mean today. In case you don't know, I mean now, I mean today, I mean now, I mean today. It's your year of sudden turnaround. Therefore, I decree your turnaround now. I decree your now turnaround. I decree your now turnaround. I decree your now turnaround. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. That's what sudden turnaround is all about. It's a now event. It's in a moment event. It's an event in a while. Just things just turn. Because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. We believe so much in the natural process that we miss out the supernatural, our supernatural heritage. You are not in the natural. Redemption has launched you into the realm of the spiritual. And that realm, the supernatural, becomes your natural estate. Therefore, from now, I decree you are coming out of this service this morning into a brand new world. It's my year of financial fortune. And now, let me tell you this. Financial fortune is only by divine empowerment. You can't walk, he said, the blessings of the Lord, it maketh rich and it has no sorrow to it. Now, what brought me out of the mentality of lack and want was a discovery of the empowerment platform for financial fortune. It's not something you cry for. It's something you plug into. It's not something you cry for. It's something you plug into. My son David, my prosperity plan, my financial fortune plan, is not a promise. It doesn't answer to your cries in prayer. It doesn't respect your fasting. It's a covenant. Until your part is played, I'm not committed. I can't launch you in there until your part is played. For the word says, but thou shalt remember the Lord your God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get away, that he may establish to you his covenant. That is his platform for your empowerment. That's no good coming about it. No title is a substitute. No calling is a substitute. That I'm an apostle, you can be an apostle and a pauper. You can be an apostle and a pauper. Your apostleship is real, but you are out of order in the covenant. That was the secret that launched me out of the realms of lack and want. That God empowers people for wealth on the platform of his covenant. You may not like it. That's his covenant. His covenant. That's what Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18 is all about. His covenant. So all we need is grace to plug into his covenant. Come and say grace.
Grace.
Grace to plug into his covenant. Grace to plug into his covenant. Grace to plug into his covenant. The greatest philanthropist in the world is a Jew. And he's given out over $4 billion. The next to him is a Jew. You know, the Jewish nature is a giving nature.
Yes, sir.
I did something for our people today at the university in trying to show them the global influence of the Jewish community. In all spheres of life, in sports, in fact, the founder of Hollywood is a Jew. A Jew had 7 Olympic medalists, 7 gold medals. The first ever. Invented all kinds of things, impacted on all realms of humanity. It is he that giveth thee power to get wealth on the platform of his covenant. His covenant. You are not poor because you are a pastor. No. You are not poor because you are a founder. You see, I'm in ministry, and you see, when you are in ministry, you have to believe everything. Get on the covenant platform.
Yes, sir.
Get on the platform of his covenant. Look, I've been in ministry ever since I've been there.
Yes, sir.
I have never begged.
Hallelujah.
I've never knocked on any member's door or mentor's door in my life for anything. All you need is your financial fortune is not in view until you plug into the covenant, until you plug into his covenant. The covenant of tithing, the covenant of seed, time and harvest, the covenant of worship offerings, the covenant of sacrifices as giving opportunity from time to time, the covenant of giving to the poor and servicing the needs of men. That's what it is. That's what I plugged into March 22nd, 1982. Man, it's flowing. He's flowing. He's flowing. He's flowing. There are many people here in this church today, world over, that are in the flow. They are in the flow because they are plugged into the covenant. And God is no respecter of persons. And he's just blessing them and blessing them and blessing them. Therefore, receive grace to plug into his covenant. Because an army of thy financial giants will rise from the platform of the liberation mandate.
Amen.
Globally.
Amen.
I told our people today at the university, I said, there is the Abrahamic blood running in my veins. I'm a Jew by root. I'm only on a mission in Nigeria. Impact is my driving force. Influence on humanity is my goal. What I have is immaterial. What I add is what matters to me. For in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Why you be over blessed? That the blessing will be blessing all humanity. Enter into that in the name of Jesus. True givers never steal. Because what they have is forgiven. So you don't steal to pay your friend's school fees. Or your friend's son's school fees. They catch you and they say, why are you stealing? They say, it's my friend's son who hasn't gone to school. No, no. You are not listed among those who steal. Or those who corner things from people. Because you are ordained to be overblessed and to be blessed to your world. That's where you are. Can I hear you say amen?
Amen?
So what do I do? Receive the power to lay down. That's your gateway to a world of financial fortune. Power to lay down. Then you are empowered to take it again. Power. He said to their power, it be a record. And beyond their power, they were willing of themselves. It takes power to be a tireless giver. Not somebody playing games and, you know, giving bribe. They call it prophet offering, no? No. Glory to God. But hear this. In the year 2015 that we are in, many have come awake now to this truth, and giants, financial giants in their numbers will rise from this platform. Somebody believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. The giant in you is coming alive. You know, naturally, giants are born of giants. How many will say amen to that? Every child of God belongs to Abrahamic covenant tree. The covenant tree of giants. Abraham, the friend of God. Abraham, the symbol of transgenerational blessing. Abraham, the great. Every child of God is a seed of Abraham. So you belong to the family of giants. So you have the DNA of giants inside you.
Hallelujah.
Can I hear your amen?
Amen?
Because you are born of the giant Abraham. You are Abraham's seed by redemption. And Abraham is a symbol of heaven's heavenly giant on the earth. And it's clear. For in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Genesis 12 verse 3. Shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Verse 2 of it. All the family, I'll make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. And I will bless him that bless them that bless, and curse him that curses thee. And in thee shall all the families of the all. One man will impart all the family. That's the family tree to which you belong. Come and say, there's a giant in me. It's coming alive this year. You see, it is your picture from scriptures that creates your future. It is your picture from scriptures that create your future. It is your picture from scriptures that create your future. 1977, I suddenly discovered that I am an eagle. From that moment, I could not entertain a vulture's mentality. No. 1977, the month of July, I saw it from Oral Roberts' study, daily study guide. Powerful. Turned in me something else. I saw me as a soaring eagle, scaling string heights. 1977. It is your picture from scriptures that creates your future. You belong to the family of giants. You belong to the family of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They were meant to be envied. They were not meant to be pitied. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I decree that your giant connection begins to manifest. Somebody believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. He said, and of Zion it shall be said, this man was born there. He said, the Almighty himself shall establish her. It shall be said of Zion, this man was born there. And verse 6, he said, the Lord shall count when he righted up the people that this man was born there. As well as the singers, as the players of instruments shall be there. All my springs are in thee, O Zion. All the names that matter in this end time shall be from church. Shall be from where? Okay, so get ready. Your children and your children's children will be manifesting in your lifetime. They'll be scaling strange heights. They will be making unusual impacts. They'll be making out of this world order of impact. Even yourself, a new day dawns on your life now. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Say with me, I belong to the family of giants. I am a kingdom giant. I belong to the family of giants. I am a kingdom giant. Is somebody excited? Glory to God. Well, God is launching me into the realms of exploits. Exploits. Whosoever believes in me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do. Ooh. What's that? Out of this world kind of exploits. Out of this world order of exploits. Going beyond where Christ stopped. Come and say, that's me. Come and say that, that's me confidently. Of all born of women, there is none as great as John the Baptist. But he that is least in the kingdom is greater than he. Matthew 11:11. What does that mean? It means every believer has a greater potential than any of the Old Testament saints. Every believer carries greater potentials within him than all the Old Testament saints. You carry greater potential than Joseph, than Abraham, than Isaac, than Jacob, than Daniel, Abba, than Job, greater potentials than Solomon, amen. Greater potentials than Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, amen. Greater potential than Nehemiah, amen. Abba, Abba, Abba. You carry Matthew that shows you belong to the realm of exploit.
Amen.
Come and say, I belong to the realm of exploit. Say convincingly. Say convincingly. 1981, October 4, the Lord showed me Daniel 11:32 and gave me the master key to a world of exploit. He said, those who do know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit. He said, you don't need to know anybody to impart on your world. Just know me. Come to know and understand what I ask you to do. Plug into it. Those who do know, not all those who know president, not those who do know governor, not those who know chairman of company, those who do know their God. God showed me 1981, October 4, is in my document, that the knowledge of God is the master key to a world of exploits. Come on now. Those who do know their God. Now, watch out for those two scriptures. They can intoxicate you any day. If you believe in me, the words that I do shall you do also. And greater works than this shall ye do. Greater works than this shall ye do. Because I go to my Father. Of all born of women, there is none as great as John the Baptist, but he that is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he. You may carry it and never manifest it. John didn't manifest it. He didn't succeed to manifest it. But you must manifest it.
Amen.
Say with me, I'm ordained for exploit.
I am ordained for exploit.
I am ordained for exploit. Haven't you heard? Arise and shine because your light is come. Now, nothing but revelation. And the glory of the Lord is raised upon you. Darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon you. The glory shall be seen. And the Gentiles will come to your light. And their kings to the brightness of your rising. And then verse 8, who are these that fly as the cloud and as the dove to their windows? Verse 22, a little one shall become a thousand, a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. It's all rooted in revelation. All rooted where?
In revelation.
Access to revelation is the gateway to a world of revolution. Everything is turning forcefully in your favor. That's revelation. Say with me, I'm ordained for exploit. So, your life is far beyond success. You are not ordained for success. You are ordained for exploit. Setting the pace.
Yes,
blazing the trail. Yes. Showing the way.
Yes.
Therefore, I release that upon you tonight in the name of Jesus. Welcome to your world of exploit. Welcome into your world of exploit. Welcome into your world of exploit. That's what makes it happen. Now, with this part, you begin to build up facts to pray in the fulfillment of these items, this prophetic agenda in your life. That's what it is. So it's merely an outline. Everyone interested now begins to build up the facts required to enforce the fulfillment of these words in their life. Don't forget, the prayer of faith is a necessary link to actualizing fulfillment of prophecy in your life. That has been the missing link. People just watch these prophecies. They just declare them. But it's far beyond that. You ward off the hands of the wicked from holding it back from you. And then you're there. Remember about how you take the shield of faith and you quench all the fiery darts of the devil. Amen. A word came, he said, I heard it from the first day that you were calling on me, but one prince of Persia stood in the way and stopped me 21 days. Now I am come for your word. An angel came and helped me. Angel Michael came and helped me and conquered that force, and now I'm here. Certain things have been held back from you for 20 days. They must be released now.
Amen.
Let me hear your loudest amen.
Amen.
They must be released now. They must be released now. Somebody believe that. Let me hear your loudest amen. I'd like you to look at anything around your life that is gone beyond a while, gone beyond a moment, gone beyond a night, gone beyond a day, and say, now is my hour. My hour has finally come to be liberated. I am now returning from here with this siege on my life. This siege must be broken this hour. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Come on, let me hear your loudest amen. That disease will not live here with you. That death sentence on your life is averted now. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Say with me, I'm not permitted to die like man. Because I'm no longer a man. By redemption, I have been empowered to become a son of God. I am now a son of God. I refuse to die like man. I am a child of God. There is a divinity within my humanity. There is divinity within my humanity. Divinity does not die. I refuse to die the way men die. Somebody already took my place and died. His name is Jesus. He through death has destroyed him that had the power of death. That is the devil. So I can be free from the fear of death. In heaven, Jesus holds the key of hell and of death, and is holding it in my favor. The devil has no power over my life. Witches cannot terminate my life. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Thank you, Father. Very quickly this morning, because I know you are living here with a testimony. You are living here with a testimony. Whatever has gone beyond the moment, list it down. Because in a moment, I will open fire. And I see them dropping off you finally forever. Very quickly, I'll take you through two things that God is saying to us for the year. Why seeking the face of the Lord concerning what the year 2015 holds? I kept hearing the voice of the Spirit say, consolidation, consolidation, consolidation. Immediately I came to the understanding that God has a consolidation agenda for us in 2015. Consolidation here implies establishment. As we all know, the ultimate quest of every organization or an individual is establishment or settlement. Consolidation also implies a review of approach through reviews and amendments as may be deemed appropriate. As I've often observed, until one is willing to change his approach, he cannot improve on his results. Therefore, without all controversy, we know that God is the great consolidator, is the great establisher of his work and his people. This is because everyone is only here for a season. Therefore, for anything to be established after one is gone, it must have to be God. As it is written, and of Zion it shall be said, this and that man was born in her. And the highest himself shall establish her. What God said to Abraham thousands of years ago is working actively among his children in their generations right now. Only God can do that. Nobody else can. But we discover from scriptures four main forces at play in the establishment of the early church. The first one is the power of prayer. You will agree with me, the early church is a most established institution. After 2,000 years, it's only growing in influence and impact. That's establishment. Establishment is all about advancement and establishment. You are advancing and with stability, there is no shaking. In your business, no more shaking. In your career, no more shaking. In your trade, no more shaking. But let's look at the four forces that were at play in the early church. The first is the power of prayer. Say with me, the power of prayer. The second is the power of the Holy Ghost. If you look at Acts chapter 2, verse 42, they were praying daily and breaking bread.
In Acts chapter 3, verse 1, there was an hour of prayer that they observed. And Peter and John were going to the temple in the hour of prayer. And we saw the apostles' teachers praying and fasting. Acts chapter 13, verse 1 to 3. Then the power of the Holy Ghost came down and came down and came down and began to establish his church. Acts chapter 2, verse 1, he came down. Acts chapter 4, verse 30 to 33, he came down. And the Holy Ghost was the force behind their glorious establishment. One of the vital forces behind their glorious establishment. He said, I saw 7 golden candlesticks with lamps on them and all of gold. And then he said to me, thus said the Lord, not by power nor by might, but by my spirit, said the Lord of God of hosts. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. So it takes the power of God to see the work of God and the people of God established in their respective areas. And then, of course, the power of the word, the power of the word. And then the power of wisdom, the power of sound reasoning. The fact that these are forces of establishment cannot be overemphasized, because the church has been growing. The church that began with 120 disciples has today grown to become a global phenomenon, and that for centuries. The church of Christ has continued to grow in power, relevance, and impact from glory to glory all through the ages. God wants us properly established as citizens of heaven this year. He wants to advance and establish this church into higher realms. God wants to establish the works of our hands as individuals, and it shall indeed be our year of advancement and settlement. How many will say amen to that? God surely has a consolation and danger for this church and individual members this year. And as we are all aware, God has ordained that whatever he does shall be forever. But that will only happen as we do whatever he commands us to do. Say with me, the power of prayer. The power of the Holy Ghost, the power of the word, and the power of wisdom. They are the stabilizing forces of destiny. They are for the establishment of destiny. I buy into them today, both for me and for this church. Let me hear your loudest amen. Let me hear your loudest amen. No more ups and downs for you in your life. No more ups and downs for you in your life. Now, this is the step to take to see God's agenda established in our lives. Introducing the covenant hour of prayer. The psalmist once declares, O Lord my God, early will I seek thee. To see thy power and thy glory. How many want to see his power and his glory? Early will I seek thee in order to see your power and your glory. Psalm 63, verse 1 to 3. God's word also asserts, they that seek me early shall find me. Proverbs 8 and verse 17. Every move of God rises on the shoulders of men, and every move of God moves people forward. There is no advancement that is not at a cost. There is nothing valuable you want to experience without a price to pay. Can I hear your amen? Let me tell you something. This church is moving to one realm that has never been known before. Because an army of men will rise from this platform that will need this establishment grace actively at work on their lives. And this is the way to get there. Every advancement of man places specific demands on his life. Paul said, but I labor more than them all. There is always a demand before we can experience a delivery. There is no technology substitute for the prayer prize for empowerment and advancement. They made a new card and put the ark of God on it. It stumbled. There is no software substitute for prayer and fasting. There is no software substitute for it. Everyone that wants to see the power and the glory of God must engage in prayers. There is no substitute for engaging the prayer altar in our quest for heaven or not experience. Jesus prayed, the heavens opened. He prayed again, the heavens came down. Can I hear your amen? Heaven must come down for each one of us this year. The Bible also admonishes that we should seek the Lord while he may be found and call upon him while he's near. We discover from scripture that God has a morning by morning appointment with his people. Amen. He has a morning by morning appointment with his people. Isaiah chapter 50 verse 4. He opened my ear morning by morning. He opened my ear to hear. And they are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. So God has a morning by morning appointment with his people. Moreover, we saw how the following maximized the early morning hours in seeking the face of God. Abraham, our covenant father. Genesis 19:27. Hear what the word says. And Abraham got up early in the morning to the place where he stood before the Lord. When did he get up? Come on, let me hear you. When did he get up? Say it loud. When did he get up? And if you are Abraham's seed, what do? You must do the works of Abraham. John chapter 8 and verse 39. We saw Jacob, the ingenious businessman, Genesis 28:18. He also got up early in the morning. Jacob rose up early in the morning and took the stone that he had put for his pillow and set it up for a pillar and poured oil on it and began to worship God. Now, Job, the business emperor, Job chapter 1 verse 5, he worshiped God morning by morning. Morning by morning. He worshiped the Lord morning by morning, and he did it continually. He rose up in the morning and offered early in the morning and offered sacrifices unto God. And he did that continually. The secret of men are in their stories. The greatness of men and women in this church, we have to buy into this secret. Can I hear your amen? Amen? Moses the prophet got up early in the morning. Exodus 34 verse 4. Got up early in the morning. Exodus 34 and verse 4. And he healed two tables of stone, like unto the first. And Moses rose up early in the morning and went up into Mount Sinai as the Lord has commanded him. Who commanded him? Who commanded early morning appointment? Who commanded early morning appointment? Who commanded early morning appointment? As the Lord commanded him. And Jesus, our Lord, a great while before dawn, he was up. Mark chapter 1, verse 35. Our God still keeps the early morning appointment with his people because I am the Lord, I change not. The early hours of the day is God's special time for his people. For day unto day uttered speech and night unto night sweat knowledge. Morning by morning. The scriptures further charge that we should not be slothful in business, but followers of those who through faith and patience inherit the promises. We cannot imagine giants except we follow the steps of giants. Can I hear your amen? In this year of heaven on earth, we have a primary obligation to maintain an effectual prayer altar, both as a commission as an individual. The early church thrived supernaturally on the pillars of prayer and the ministry of the word. It is in the light of this that the covenant hour of prayer is hereby inaugurated in all our churches worldwide. Come on, give the Lord a big hand. It shall be a 1 hour prayer time that shall hold between 5:30 and 6:30 every morning. Glory to God. Between the hour, now you see, you don't have to be interested. It's simply an obligation. And God does not need a crowd to get a job done. Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them. This is fire burning on the altar. This is the birthplace of giants. This is where the giants God has ordained will be born. He said, who has had such a thing, who has seen such a thing. Before she traveled, she brought forth. Before her parents came, she was delivered of a man child. Can a nation be born at once? But as soon as Zion traveled, what happens? She brought forth her children. This is going to be the most awesome step this church has ever taken. And can I tell you this? This is for life. This is for what? This is for life. Is somebody excited here? Come and give the Lord a big hand of praise. This shall be for life. And it takes off on Monday 16th of this month in all our churches worldwide. Where the need for change of time comes in any place, for whatever reasons that could be, it will all be adjusted and fixed according to each nation's needs or each location's requirements. Can I hear your amen? But that flags off on the 16th of March, the year 2015, in all our churches worldwide. 1 hour only. And there's also a slot of 15 minutes personal supplication within that schedule. There is intercessions and there is personal supplication. So we take hold of the day before it begins. And we take hold of the day to be on top of it every day. And to be on top of the issues of your life every day. Can I hear your amen? Amen. Nothing of value is ever free. Just check on the agenda of many giants. You see how many hours they have logged in God's presence. We can pray in our homes, but he has asked us to gather. Amen? Because he wants to manifest himself to us in our midst. And he's going to do that in Jesus' name. Is somebody excited here? Somebody said here, he said, I came to this church 2014 in our testimony. He said, I'm glad that here they tell people to pray for themselves. So nobody's playing on you. Nobody's playing smart on anyone. It's how much you invest as individuals that determines the outcome of your life. Let me hear your loudest amen. Amen. That's what is going to happen, and that takes place on the 16th of this month. This prayer movement shall surely usher this commission into higher realms of dominion, with multitudes being drafted into the church through the wonders of answered prayers. Remember, it is written, thus saith the Lord of hosts. It shall yet come to pass that there shall come people and the inhabitants of many cities, and the inhabitants of one city shall go to another, saying, let us go speedily to pray before the Lord and to seek the Lord of hosts. I will go also. That's Zechariah chapter 8, verse 20 and 21. That is, the tempo of answers to prayers will be drafting multitudes into his presence. Can I hear your amen? Is somebody excited here? Every time God tells you what to do, it means he wants to do something strange. Every time God shows you what to do, he wants to do something unusual around your life. I can sense in my spirit that God is launching this commission and the men and brethren that are in it into the realities of the realms of heaven on earth. You believe you are there? Let me hear your loudest amen. Come on, stand to your feet right now. Let everybody consciously receive the spirit of grace and supplications to match this new demand. Come and lift up your two hands to heaven. I receive the spirit of grace and supplication to match the prayer demands of this season. Prayer from the depth of your heart.
I receive the spirit of grace and supplication to meet the prayer demands of this season. I refuse to lose my place to carelessness and spiritual laxity. Help me, Jesus. Everybody lift up your hands and pray in the spirit. Pray your way into this new realm of prayer. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. Why do we gather upon Mount Zion? There shall be what? Deliverance. God has ordained church as a platform of deliverance from all oppressions of the devil. And what happens? When we come to Mount Zion, we have come to the blood of sprinkling that speaks better things than the blood of Abel. We have come to God, the judge of all, to justify us of the accusers that are accusing us. That's what differentiates the church from your house. Your house and the church are not the same. You try not coming to church for 5 weeks, you will be lost. You will need to be saved, because the forces that set free, you have not appeared. You have not made yourself available to it. Please understand, God never placed a burden on people.
No.
But every demand of the kingdom is for our advancement.
Yes, sir.
Every demand of the kingdom is for our advancement. Every demand of the kingdom is for our advancement. Every demand of the kingdom is for my advancement. Every demand of the kingdom is for my advancement. Every demand of the kingdom is for my advancement. Every demand of the kingdom is for my advancement. Therefore, receive grace to be a full partaker of this new demand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God said to me, as a result of this covenant hour of prayer, heaven on earth and wonders without end shall become the new realm of every winner all through the year 2015 and beyond. All through the year 2015 and beyond. Where do we come to church? He said, and Savior shall he emerge upon Mount Zion. Where would they emerge from? Where would they emerge from? Where would the Saviors emerge from? Where would the Saviors emerge from? He took Abraham out to a place where I will meet with him. It took him 3 days to get there. And there he said to him, by myself have I sworn that in blessing, I will bless you. In multiplying, I will multiply thy seed and the sand of the sea. And thy seed shall all the nations of the earth. And your seed shall possess the gates of their enemy. It took him far to change his life. Glory to God. We are going to encounter God. We are going to encounter God. We are going to encounter God in the name of Jesus. Therefore, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, this covenant hour of prayer is hereby flagged off for the advancement of both this commission and individual members of the Winners Family worldwide, beginning from Monday the 16th, March 2015. Jesus is Lord! Lift up your two hands and celebrate God right now. Celebrate God right now. Magnify God right now. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Now, listen to this. God sent me as a prophet over this commission and a prophet to the nations of the world. And I'm speaking by that prophetic authority right now. Whatever has outlived a while
and a moment in your life. Take off your shoes, everybody. Riadi shagalo praki anotazizo. Improtika resko rabia yesha. If anybody is carrying any plague on his or her body, put your hand on it. Ziareso kita krodia le shambara katanu aluto. On the spot, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, a supernatural change is taking place in your life right now. That elderly woman said, I had this swollen tummy. And you said we should put our hands on any area that's hurting us. I put my hand on that tummy and it went down as you prayed. Look at me. Now, whatever came here with you as an emblem of the wicked, whatever is tormenting your life in one way or another, the word of God says we cannot lie. He said, in a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, in the twinkle of an eye, we shall be changed. We shall be what?
Changed.
Whatever change you require and you desire, receive it now. That death sentence over your life is averted this moment. Every growth and swelling on your body is declared deflated. Every disease in your body is caused from the roots. For our light affliction is permitted only for a moment, but it worketh for us a far more exceeding eternal weight of glory. Therefore, because it's outlived a moment talks about a second, I command right now that affliction to drop off you in the name of Jesus. He said, after you have suffered a while, now it's over a while. You have been sitting down here for more than a while. Therefore, I decree that every negative thing that followed you to the one night with the king, this night is over in the name of Jesus. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, be healed in the name of Jesus. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed in the name of Jesus. I command your eyes to be healed. I command your ears to be healed. I command your heart to be healed. I command your kidney and your lungs to be healed. I command your liver to be healed. I command your nurses to be healed. That migraine is caused from the root. That asthma is rooted out of your life. That chest pain is gone forever. In the name of Jesus. Every deformity in your body, crippleness, stroke, any form of deformity that may be on your body, it has overstayed its time. It has expired according to the word of God. So I command every deformity cleared off in the name of Jesus. You believe in your instant testimony? Receive it now! 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 Thank you, Father. Everything blocking your fruitfulness is cursed right now. Impotency is cursed right now. Infertility is cursed right now. And you are set free. Choir, please get on the stand. We are going to sing and dance. God has touched you, just carry your Bible and come on here. We just wave your hand and then we go home. Hallelujah. Everybody's waking up. Keep your shoes where they are, please. Keep your shoes where they are. We are in God's presence. We are just tapping into the virtues of the moment. Everything that is contrary to this prophetic verdict must turn to a testimony this morning. Has turned to a testimony right now. Come on now, choir, let's praise him. Glory to God. Quick, please move on.
Jehovah turns my life around. Jehovah turns my life around. He makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say. Jehovah turns my life around. Jehovah turns my life around.
He
makes a way where there seems to be no way. Jehovah.
Prophetic ministration, start, take your Bibles and your Bibles and be on your way down here in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on now, 1 minute.
It's the dawning of a new day. It's the dawning of a new day. He has done the dawning of a new day. It's the dawning of a new day.
Lift up your two hands to heaven everywhere. These instant testimonies are pointers to the fact that whatever you stood for has been delivered to you. It's now your turn for celebration. Lift up those two hands and begin to celebrate God right there where you are. Begin to appreciate Him for the hand of God that is upon you. Bless His name for His hand that is upon you. Every expired issue is turned to a testimony in your life. Every expired issue is turned to a testimony in your life. We have only 2 more minutes to go. In Jesus' name. Please get seated in all of the centers. Please, you can share your testimonies in 3 minutes. We are out of this service at 5:05. Please. Please get seated, everyone. Let's read a few of these testimonies. And you stop it when it's 2 minutes, 30 minutes, 30 seconds, please. Quick.
Hallelujah. Joseph Wodo has been asthmatic for over 14 years. But in the course of the service, he believed God for a touch. And now he's free from that asthma. Somebody give God praise.
Has been what?
Asthma. 14 years asthma. Okay. Prince Israel, 4 years chest pain healed. Shade Oladipupo, 3 years chronic toothache healed.
Amen.
Faith Enejume had a swollen abdomen for over 3 years, but in the course of the service, God flattened out that abdomen. Come on, somebody give God
Hallelujah.
Praise.
Hallelujah.
Akwao Imaobong, 1 year left side waist pain healed. Andy Njoku, 6 months ulcer disappeared.
Amen.
Pedro Modupe Ola, 4 months back pain healed.
Amen.
Oluoye Tolulope, over 1 year chronic cough gone. Mr. Aino, over 6 months chronic headache gone.
Amen.
Eze Chidima, 30 years abdominal pain that required a surgery before he came in here, but God has healed him. No more surgery. Pain has gone. Hallelujah. Dara Ifoma, 15 years short-sightedness healed. Nike had a scorpion bite over 2 years ago and has been having pain in the leg, but God has healed her in the course of the service. No more pain from that previous scorpion bite. Lukman Afolabi had a case of impotency, but God restored him in the service.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Mary Orik, over 10 years leg pain gone. Hallelujah.
Shall we all rise to our feet? Very humorous God, He has done it again. Impotency healed. Swollen tummy for 15 years gone. Lift up your 2 hands and celebrate God. Magnify Him, glorify Him. Thank you for all these testimonies. We couldn't go any far at all, but we have the records thereof, and we celebrate you, God, for it. Every testimony is significant. Every testimony is important. We give you glory and praise. In Jesus' precious name, so shall it be. Just in a moment before we share the goodness, I'd like you to see this month as a very pivotal month to the events of this year, because it is only faith that makes heaven on earth a reality. Therefore, in this month of faith, I'd like to admonish you to invest maximally in developing your faith. Invest maximally in reading widely, in
searching tirelessly. Make a project of any issue that you desire a turnaround from on. Make a project of them. This man must answer to you to the fullest. Mind the books recommended. You have most of them on your shelf. Pick on one. I'd like to even recommend that everybody gets on the unlimited power of faith. And change your level permanently. Change your level permanently. Sit down with the word. Identify your project. Define them appropriately. Reach out for the source materials that will help you. And then settle in to build your faith. And with your altar of the prayer of faith, you are sure to deliver. You are sure to deliver. This is a month of change of story for you. All that you have believed God for, since the 21 days of prayer and fasting, you shall be taking harvest of testimonies now. Lift up those two hands. Please get back to your seat, everyone here. Jesus is Lord. Lift up those two hands. Go in peace. Tomorrow is Sunday. Return with your testimonies tomorrow. Jesus said to the lepers, go and show yourself to the priest. And as they went, they were cleansed. Therefore, as you go, the balance of your delivery for tonight is delivered. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. The Consolidation Agenda 2015 will call for necessary structural reviews. And as they come, grace to plug in without being rebellious, grace to plug in faithfully. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Also understand that every heavenly pattern is delivered through a man. He delivered through a man, not through a group. He said to Moses, see that you do all things according to the pattern shown to you on the mountain. He shows it to his man. His man reveals it to his people. God is not a Democrat. Glory to God. Glory to God. So please ensure you plug into this wave and then you will find results at the end of the day. It's wonderful to be a genuine follower. Every genuine follower ends up a leader. Yes. You must end up a leader. Yeah. Can I hear your loudest amen? Yeah. For instance, we have reclassified our churches and given new nomenclature to each grouping of the churches. That is as the pattern reveals to us. Can I hear your amen? Yeah. And I believe that this year will be the greatest year ever in the life of every winner. Amen. You may not look like you are anywhere now, but I can tell you this. Before this month is over, you are somewhere where you are shedding tears of joy. Throughout this year, no one buries any man in his family. No one suffers any assault from the wicked one. And as we gather on Sunday at our covenant day of exemption, 1,000 may fall on your right, 10,000 on your left. They will never come near you. 1,000 business may collapse on this side, 10,000 on that side, your own will keep growing. You shall never be involved in any form of accident. There shall be no blood shed on anyone in your family. Every day shall remain Christmas for you this year. It is your year of financial fortune. The giant in you is coming alive. Sudden turnaround remains your portion. In the name of Jesus, be blessed in your going out. Be blessed in your coming in. Thank you, Father. Lift up those two hands and together, let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship, everybody. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. Is heaven on earth and wonders without end? Come and help me give it to two people around you here.
That's my new realm, and your new realm, and that's my new realm, and your new realm. Come on, give the Lord praise, everybody. Good morning, have the best of the day. In Jesus' name.